Hi students, today we are going to start one new chapter called Linear Algebra. In this chapter, we are going to study one more algebraic structure called vector space. What is the definition of vector space? Let F be a field and V be a non-empty set. In V, we define the following operations of addition and scalar multiplication, that is alpha plus beta and C alpha. Alpha and beta are the elements of V, C is the element of field F. Then the set V is called a vector space over the field F if the following axioms are satisfied. See here, F is a field, V is a non-empty set. Here in V, we define the operations of addition and scalar multiplication. Here alpha plus B is addition. Alpha and beta are the elements of V. C alpha is a scalar multiplication. C is the element of F. Alpha is the element of V. Then the set V is called a vector space if it satisfies these four axioms. That is, first one, V plus C is abelian group. V plus C is abelian group, nothing but closure property holds under addition. Associative property holds, additive identity exists, additive inverse exists, and the commutative property holds under addition. Second one, if C into alpha plus beta equals C into alpha plus C into beta, and C1 plus C2 into alpha equals C1 alpha plus C2 alpha. Third condition, C1 into C2 into alpha equals C1 into C2 alpha. Fourth condition, 1 into alpha equals alpha. Here alpha and beta are the elements of V, C1, C2 are the elements of F. There is no C3, right? C1 and C2 belongs to F. The vector space over the field F is denoted by this symbol, V of F. The elements of F are called scalars and the elements of V are called vectors. The identity of the group V plus is called zero vector. Zero vector is the identity. Null vector denoted by zero, which is unique. This is 2-mark question. Define vector space. Okay. Let me see one example. Example, the set of all ordered pairs x1, x2 of the elements of the field of real numbers forms a vector space with respect to addition and scalar multiplication, defined as x1 x2 plus y1 y2 equals x1 plus y1 x2 plus y2. C into x1 into x2 equals c x1 comma c into x2 c x2. Okay, solution. First write V. V of R is the set of ordered pairs, ordered pair x1 x2 such that elements of the field of real numbers, these are elements of real numbers, x1 and x2 belongs to R, be the set of ordered pairs. Each ordered pair is a vector. Here first take any three elements alpha, beta, gamma belongs to this set. Here alpha is of the form x1 x2, beta is of the form y1 y2, gamma is of the form z1, z2. X1, x2, y1, y2, z1, z2 are real numbers. First, we show that V of R is abelian group. Okay, under addition, first condition, closure property should holds good. X1, x2 plus y1, y2. X1, x2 is the element of V. Y1, y2 is the element of V. Their addition is of the form x1 plus y1, x2 plus y2. This is also element of V. Therefore, V of R is closed under addition. Next, for every alpha, beta, gamma belongs to V of R, such that alpha plus beta plus gamma equals alpha plus beta plus gamma. Now, take all LHS. Alpha plus beta plus gamma. Alpha is x1, x2. Beta plus gamma is y1, y2 plus z1, z2. This can be written as y1 plus z1 comma y2 plus z2. Okay. Next, this step can be written as lower bracket x1 plus y1 plus z comma x2 plus y2 plus z bracket. Here these are the elements or numbers. these are belongs to a set of real numbers. In real numbers, commutative property holds good, associative property holds good. Therefore, this can be written as x1 plus y1 plus z1, x2 plus y2 plus z2. This can be written as x1 plus y1, comma x2 plus z2 plus ordered pair z1, z2. This is x1, x2, y1, y2, z1, z2. This is alpha, flower bracket alpha plus this is beta, bracket complete plus gamma, associative law holds under addition. Third one, let 0 equals 0 comma 0 belongs to vector space V such that alpha plus 0 equals alpha x1 x2 plus 0 comma 0 x1 plus 0 x2 plus 0 x1 plus 0 is x1, x2 plus 0 is x2. This is alpha. Alpha plus 0 equals alpha. Therefore, 0 is additive identity in V of R. Next, for every alpha x1, x2 belongs to V, then there exist minus alpha equals minus alpha minus x1 minus x2 belongs to V, such that alpha plus of minus alpha equals x1 x2 plus of minus x1 minus x2, x1 plus of minus x1, x2 plus of minus x2. Plus of minus is minus, x1 minus x1 is 0, x2 minus x2 is 0. Alpha plus of minus alpha is 0, nothing but minus alpha is additive inverse of alpha or negative of alpha, both are same. Minus alpha is additive inverse of alpha. Next one, consider alpha plus beta. Alpha x1 comma x2 plus beta is y1 comma y2. X1 plus y1 comma x2 plus y2. X1 plus y1 can be written as y1 plus x1. This can be written as y2 plus x2. This is y1 comma y2. Y1 comma y2, this is x1 comma x2. Plus y1 comma y2 is beta plus x1 comma x2 is alpha. Commutative law holds in V. Therefore, V plus is abelian group. Next one, V2. By hypothesis, for every alpha belongs to V, C belongs to F such that C alpha belongs to V. C alpha equals C of x1 comma x2. Next equals C into x1 cx1 comma C into x2 cx2 belongs to V. Therefore, V is closed under multiplication. V is closed under multiplication. First one, for every alpha beta belongs to V, C belongs to F. Here F nothing but R, such that C of alpha plus beta equals C of alpha plus beta is x1 plus y1, x2 plus y2. C into x1 plus y1 comma C into x2 plus y2. C into x1, cx1 plus C into y1, cy1, cx2 plus cy2. Cx1, cx2 ordered pair cx1 comma cx2 plus ordered pair cy1 comma cy2. C is common ordered pair x1 comma x2 plus C is common ordered pair y1 comma y2. This is alpha, this is beta. C alpha plus C beta. Second condition, for every alpha belongs to V, C1 and C2 are elements of F such that C1 plus C2 alpha, C1 plus C2 alpha is x1 x2, C1 plus C2 into x1 comma C1 plus C2 into x2, C1 x1 plus C2 x1, C1 x2 plus C2 x2, C1 x1 comma C1 x2 plus C2 x1 comma C2 x2. Here C1 common, x1 comma x2 plus C2 is common, x1 comma x2. This is alpha, C1 alpha plus this is also alpha, C2 alpha. So two conditions source good. Third one, C1 C2 into alpha. C1 C2 alpha is x1 comma x2. C1 C2 x1 comma C1 C2 x2. This can be written as C1 into C2 x1 comma C1 into C2 x2. take c1 common, c2 x1, c2 x2, again take c2 common, x1 x2, c1 into c2, this is alpha. Third condition holds good. Fourth one, 1 into alpha equals 1 into x1 comma x2, this is ordered pair. 1 into x1 comma 1 into x2, 1 into x1 is x1 comma 1 into x2 is x2, x1 comma x2 is alpha. Therefore, all axioms of vector space are satisfied. Therefore, V is a vector space over the field of real numbers.